Most of us are familiar with the black and white uniform of St Jahn Ambulance. Today, with its modern image of bright yellow jackets and green first aid kits, the organisation still depends on volunteers, and this goes back many years.
I've often thought about joining your lot. So he said, don't think about it, join us. He said, we need all the personnel we can get. So he got on talking and he said, do you know Tom Keyes? I said, yeah, I know Tom Keyes, member of my church. So he said, well, go and have a word with him and he'll direct you to where you got to go. So I had a word with Tom and he sent me out to Fawcett Road Methodist Church, where the Milton Nursing Division then met, and their superintendent was Miss Bull. But I'll be honest with you, had I realised what it involved, I don't know that I would have joined it, because it involved a lot of outside duties that you didn't know if you were capable of doing, really. I mean, I'd only just passed me. I hadn't passed it then. I just went there, and then I had to join up with a creed that we're going to do it. That's when Dr. Mabry, he trained us, and we anyway, I passed it.
Well, of course, St John's could always be seen in the crowd, their black and white uniform. I was a relatively inexperienced member, although I was old in years. Used to report to our porter cabin down on the South Sea front there. And we used to get our orders from there. And I was dispatched off with others, just sat in this little old van. And we went down to our new port of call, which was, I think, called Castle Field in those days. And before we even got there, we came across their first casualty. Young lad on a motorbike had turned right across the main stream of the traffic. He lay on the floor there. His ankle was very, very badly damaged. We all got out. We applied the initial first aid. We got it all free from the bike and supported it. And fortunately, we didn't need to take him to QA because County Ambulance came up at that point and took over.
There were four beach huts. There was one at the far end, near when you come down from Henderson Road, right down on the beach there. But we never ever had much to do there, because the people that were on the beach were further down, and it was not the right place for it. So eventually the council gave us another hut, and that was when you come down St George's Road. On the right-hand side, when, before you turn around, there was toilets. And it was opposite there. There was an area there. And a row of beach huts that people hired. And our little hut was on its isolated on its own, but it was a nice little hut. But you only ever went on duty in pairs, because no huts were provided with telephone. So if you needed an ambulance or a doctor or anything, somebody had to go to the phone box, which was round the corner, and you had to leave somebody in charge of the patient, of course. South Sea Nursing Division did one further along, where when you get along going towards South Parade Pier, there were a lot of kiosks and things there. It was Portsmouth Nursing had the hut there. And the other one was on the common, and that was the Clarence Pier End one, and that was manned by the men, always manned by the men. I don't know where they got on for help when they needed it, but it all worked out, you know.
Since the very first division was formed in Portsmouth in 1895, The brigade, as it was then called, had to work without a combined headquarters. In 1956, Princess Margaret opened the new headquarters for Portsmouth, where she was accompanied by officers of St John Ambulance, Lieutenant General Sir Henry Pownall, along with the Countess Mountbatten, who was the superintendent in chief. The corps chaplain, Canon W.J. Smith, led the service in the new hall. Today, the site of the headquarters has now long since gone, and with no trace of what was once the pride of St John in Portsmouth, has now modern-day housing in its place. However, it is just south of the original site stands the present headquarters of St John Ambulance in Portsmouth. St John can be seen attending many of the sporting events, including football matches.
Thank you very much.
The local parades and carnivals held also attract volunteers to join the organisation from other parts of the country.
I came here because my firm were about to build what everyone now knows as Zurich Insurance, their international headquarters. And I will say right now that it was the best 4 years I ever had being in Portsmouth. When you move, one of the beauties of belonging to the family of St John is that it doesn't matter where you move, you simply look up or phone, find the nearest St John unit and phone them and say, hello, I'm whoever I am, go down there, you're always welcome there, and I was in Portsmouth. What then became fairly obvious was that Portsmouth Ambulance Division, as was, had this wonderful old ambulance, but it was a wonderful old ambulance. And because I have this love of things to do with fundraising and public relations, I said, OK, I'll take on that challenge. We'll get ourselves another ambulance. We've got to. And looking back through all the old press cuttings, I can't believe some of the things that I said, but I did say them. And they were essentially all true. And so we started on fundraising. Now, for anyone who's ever done any fundraising, it looks easy, but by heavens, it isn't. You have to find something that appeals to people somewhere. And again, Portsmouth, as I said earlier, it's got a very distinct character and a very distinct population, even within Hampshire. And people did start to respond. What we unfortunately ran up against was, at the time, Portsmouth Football Club were in bigger trouble than we were. And they'd also started the SOS Pompey appeal, which did us no favours whatsoever. So we had to look for any way we could to try and get some funds in. But it was very hard work. So there we are, we'd done it. We'd got the new vehicle. It was absolutely the best that we could do with the knowledge that we had at the time. It was badged up with all the St John devices. We checked everything. It was the absolute pipe dream come true. And I just hope that it, over the years, it gave excellent service to the community.
Once the basic training has been completed, many members can go on to specialise in other fields, one of these being ambulance aid, and where the training is to a high standard throughout. Training plays an important role within St John, and after that, if you have the time, you can take in the sights as well as making sure things are running to plan, and at the same time keeping your eye on the general public.
Well, on a normal parade night, we would do a little bit of drill, and then most of the evening was spent doing formal lectures and practical work to back up the lectures. later years, of course, I did a lot of teaching because I was a qualified nurse. We would do first aid, we would do our caring course, and of course we'd also learn about caring for people while they're aboard the ambulance. Often had competitions both within the division and within the local divisions, and I collected a few cups and trophies for that over the years. This won one of the plaques. This was awarded for the number of nursing hours that we did, which was sort of a new trophy, and I used to win this most years because a lot of my voluntary work was done in the A&E department at the old Hasler Hospital, and that's how I collected that and how I collected the hours for that. Well, over the years we did lots of interesting duties. There was the sports side, which I didn't get really involved with. The other side was, of course, the places like the King's Theatre. We would cover a lot of the shows there. We would cover things at the Guildhall, everything from the Bournemouth Symphony Orchestra, the graduation ceremonies, even the beer festivals. And I was with St John, about 12 years, and I thoroughly enjoyed myself. We had our ups and downs, but generally it was a very, very enjoyable 12 years.
With modern equipment and vehicles on show, Portsmouth Seafront can be a busy venue for St John.